Thank you. 各位傳媒朋友，多謝大家今日嚟呢個記者會。唔好意思，我哋遲咗十分鐘，要大家久等。稍後咧，行政長官同埋官員咧會先向大家發言，之後會接受大家嘅提問嘅。如果冇問題，我哋先請行政長官。
各位傳媒朋友，各位香港市民，我先同大家交代一下最新嘅疫情嘅情況。根據衛生署衛生防護中心嘅資料，截至到今日上午九時。世界各地至少有175宗新型冠狀病毒感染個案。我們留意到內地的疫情持續，個案數目不斷上升。根據國家衛生健康委員會的資料，截至到昨日午夜12時，內地個案總數是24,324宗，增加了3,887宗的個案。當中16,678宗是出現在湖北省的。至於香港方面，疫情呢亦都有惡化的趨勢。一方面，昨日和今天香港一共是新增了6宗的確診個案，截至到今日下午3時，總確診個案數目是21宗。根據現有的資料，昨日新增的3宗個案的病人在潛伏期內都沒有外遊，亦都未能找到明顯的病源，屬於本地感染個案。這3宗本地感染個案是令人憂慮的，或者顯示香港已經出現了社區的傳播。未來14日將會是十分關鍵，我們需要防止病毒在社區擴散。第二方面的疫情的發展是在21宗的確診個案中，其中一名病人昨日早上病情急轉直下，經搶救後不治。由於病人自確診後一直情況穩定，直至到昨日早上突然惡化，醫生認為未能夠解釋他的死因，所以已經轉介死因裁判官跟進。另外，目前有兩名病人情況是危殆的。特區政府在今次的防控疫情的工作，我們的策略一直是以預防和減少病毒感染傳播為目標，但是採取的措施是會按住疫情的不斷變化，徵詢專家的意見，顧及香港的實際情況，作出相應的調整。由於昨日確診3宗社區的感染個案，疫情呢個發展可以講是進入另一個嚴峻的階段，政府有需要採取更加嚴厲的措施，同市民一起盡最大的努力，將這個疫情減慢。昨日我是邀請了4位專家顧問團的成員，聽取他們的意見。今日我會宣布進一步壓縮香港和內地的跨境人流的措施。在講這個新措施之前，我想跟大家交代一下，昨日即是2月4日，我們暫停了另外4個口岸跨境服務的成效。一如好像上一次的情況，也就是說我們在1月30日起呢是暫停了6個的口岸。這一次再暫停4個口岸的成效是顯著，甚至可以說呢是立竿見影。以下是措施生效前和措施生效后的比较，换句话说，是将昨天2月4日的数字和前一日2月3日是作一个比较。第一个数字是在机场以外的口岸总入境的人次，大家都会记得了，现在是剩下两个口岸，分别是深圳湾的口岸和港珠澳大桥的香港口岸。措施生效前2月3日是錄得78,954的人次，昨天亦都是措施生效之後呢是下跌了 64%， 總的人次是28,675。另一個數字是機場，機場的入境人數在生效前是52,050，生效後是41,137，下降了21%。但是絕大部分由機場入境香港的其實是國際的旅客，很多都不是在內地來的。但是我留意到有坊間也都說不是，在機場見到好像有幾千名都是內地的旅客，所以在這裡今天第一次跟大家去分析這個數字。在最新的數字，由機場入境的內地旅客，即是說他是持有一個中國護照的旅客，是有6,039人，這個是昨天的數字。但是入境處經過特別詳細的去分析，就發覺如果是由內地坐飛機飛入香港國際機場的中國護照持有人，其實只得224名，是佔總數的3.7%。其他那些呢，他是揸住中國的護照，是一個內地的旅客，但是其實他不是在內地來的，他是在其他很多很多 的其他的城市呢是抵港的。第三個比較的數字是香港居民經過現在正如運作的兩個陸路口岸回香港的情況，措施生效前是69,825，昨天措施生效之後是23,643，下跌的幅度是66%。而大家記得啦，每次講除了入境的數字，有一個出境的數字對於我們今次的防控疾病的工作是重要，就是香港居民離開我們香港，在這些陸路口岸回內地，他們那個重要性呢，就是我們相信大部分離港入內地的香港居民呢，他都會沒多久呢，甚至即日呢會回來香港的。所以這個數字都是從防控疫情那裡是有一個重要性。在措施生效前呢，我都跟大家講過這個數字都是高的，就是41,031。措施生效後的昨天呢，是下跌的幅度都不少，就是有14,218，下跌的幅度呢是65%。相信上述的數字呢，是會隨著市民的防疫意識提高，以及我們減少到口岸的公共交通的班次呢，是會再下降的。但是考慮到疫情的最新情況，我們認為目前經陸路口岸由內地入香港的總人次，即仍然有成28,000多的人次呢，仍然是需要加大力度來對壓縮。同樣地，如果每日還有超過14,000名的香港居民到內地呢，這個亦都是應該有壓縮的空間。我們進一步的措施呢，必須要顧及其實超過80%從內地抵港的都是香港居民，我們不能夠將這些香港居民拒諸門外。由2月1日到2月4日這4日，香港居民佔由內地抵港的比例呢，都是很持續，是超過80%，是分別由82%到最高的88%，都是香港的居民。考慮了上述的情況和疫情的最新發展，以及香港的實際的需要，我現在宣布行政長官會同行政會議將會引用《預防及控制疾病條例》，亦即是香港法例的第599章的權力，制定附屬法例，要求從內地入境的人士，包括香港居民、內地居民和其他旅客，是需要強制接受檢疫14天。行政會議在昨天的會議上呢，已經是原則上同意採納這個建議了。事實上，這個亦都是我們今次防控疫情工作上第二次去引用這條條例。在1月8日，我們是將嚴重新型傳染性病原體呼吸系統病納入了這條條例下面，定為是需要呈報的傳染病。大家留意是1月8日， 我哋喺好早呢已經係為呢次防疫嘅工作做好一個法律嘅手段啦。但至於今次第二次引用呢條條例嚟到去做呢個強制嘅檢疫嘅工作，有關呢條附屬法例嘅詳情，以至到檢疫嘅安排咧，食物及衛生局同埋相關嘅部門咧會再作公布。我哋希望呢個措施咧係喺2月8日凌晨生效，因為仲要進行嗰個法律嘅工作啦。但最重要咧係被受影響嘅市民可以由而家喺未來2天作出所需要嘅安排。呢個今日公布嘅進一步嘅措施咧係嚴厲嘅，因為大家都可以預計啦，從內地入境嘅人士，如果佢跨境之後需要接受強制檢疫14日，如果佢嚟香港唔係必要或者緊急，佢係唔會嚟香港嘅。而香港居民知道離港之後再翻嚟，亦都會要接受強制檢疫14日，相信咧亦都唔會係隨意咁離開香港翻到內地。由於人流已經大幅下降，我哋相信咧跨境嘅運輸服務亦都會相應減少。事實上，照我哋了解咧，國泰航空同埋佢全資附屬公司國泰港龍航空，正係逐步削減往嚟香港、往來香港同埋內地嘅定期客運航班，只係提供前往4個地點嘅航班服務，分別係北京每日2班、上海每日2班、廈門每日1班同埋成都1星期4班，減幅係達到90%。同樣喺跨境嘅巴士服務或者其他公共嘅交通服務，以至到接駁去到深圳灣口岸嘅公交服務咧，亦都會相應作出調整。此外，特區政府亦都會即時暫停啟德郵輪碼頭同埋海運大廈郵輪碼頭嘅口岸出入境服務。至於今日有一艘泊岸嘅郵輪嘅最新情況，稍後我請衛生署署長咧再同大家解釋。要有效減低社區嘅傳播咧，我哋係需要加大力度減少社會接觸，亦即係一直我哋講嘅 social distancing。我哋曾經亦都仍然係有效嘅措施，包括停課、喺屋企工作、暫停部分嘅公共服務、取消社交嘅活動，同埋勸喻市民避免去一啲人多嘅場所。我喺呢度再次強烈呼籲各位市民要配合呢個策略。企業亦都要就雇員工作嘅安排彈性處理，市民如非必要要留喺屋企，如果需要外出咧，要注意個人嘅衛生，做好防備，包括有需要嘅時候咧係佩戴口罩。喺呢度，我需要為我昨日就戴口罩嘅言論，因為表達唔清楚而引起咗誤會道歉。實情係我當時想指出咧，政府是需要優先照顧醫護和前線提供公共服務的人員的口罩需要，所以我們會因應風險評估原則決定官員是否是需要在公開的場合佩戴口罩。我當時講的對象是主要的官員，我鼓勵他們要以身作則，減少在不必要的情況之下佩戴口罩，來到去減低這個容量。我明白越趨嚴厲的防疫防控措施是會對不少的香港市民帶來影響，例如是現在每日跨境工作的人。我已經要求勞工及福利局局長是盡快制定一個方案，為因此受到影響的僱員和僱主提供所需的協助。而特區政府亦都會盡快成立超過100億元的防疫抗疫基金，提供所需的支援，詳情咧稍後會公布。另一方面，特區政府咧亦都係正檢視早前因為經濟下行啦，同埋社會事件推出的多輪舒緩措施。我哋會延長呢些措施的有效期，甚至係加大力度。對於受影響的各行各業，特別是要繳交商鋪租金的商户，我喺呢度呼籲各位業主 本住同舟共濟的精神，為這些商戶提供協助。各位市民，面對今次嚴峻的疫情，特區政府一直都是嚴陣以待，以保障市民健康、公共安全和社會穩定為大原則。我們聽取了公共衛生和醫療專家的意見，參考科學數據，在考慮公共衛生風險和香港實際情況，採取一系列的防疫抗疫措施。除了醫療方面的工作，我們致力減少跨境人流和減少社區接觸，但由於香港和內地在經濟、社會和民生各方面都聯繫緊密，而人員往來很頻繁，要完全一刀切地切斷兩地的人流並不切實可行，亦都可能會影響市民很關心的食品和日用品的供應。我們在過去一個星期推出的三輪關乎口岸的措施，已經說明是可以有效地大幅度削減跨境的人流，減低風險。但我們今天亦都按住最新的疫情和最新的數據，再提出進一步的措施。面對疫情的最新發展，我們每一步都要小心應對，謹慎從事。香港有穩健的醫療系統，有優秀的醫護人員，防疫意識很高的市民，現在實在是需要我們同心團結，本住共同的目標，放下分歧，共同為香港打贏這場抗疫戰。我現在先請衛生署署長和大家交代一下有關這一艘停泊在啟德郵輪碼頭的郵輪的最新情況。請陳署長。
好，今天衛生署的港口衛生科呢，就是去到啟德郵輪碼頭呢進行這個調查，事源就是一艘由曾經在今年的11月19日至24日，當時這個遊船呢是有一批乘客在南沙，這個旅程呢是去越南的。那我們就得悉呢，該批乘客裏面呢當中呢是有8位人士呢是被證明是有確診這個新型的冠狀病毒。那這批乘客這個行程呢已經完了的了。咁佢今次嚟香港咧，因為香港係佢翻嚟嘅home port， 即係個嘅母港嚟嘅。咁所以我哋港口衛生科嘅同事咧，就去到調查。咁之前咧就已經要求船上嘅所有船員同埋乘客咧，係喺船上咧係填報個衛生嘅申報。咁初步了解咧，呢一批船裏邊咧就有1800多位乘客，咁當中咧應該超過90%咧係香港嘅市民，其他咧就係其他國籍嘅人士。據目前嘅了解咧，就冇內地嘅乘客。此外，亦都有1800多位嘅船上嘅工作人員。咁詳情咧，我而家請我嘅同事港口衛生主任梁耀康醫生咧，係講一講佢哋進行調查最新嘅情況。
或者我再交代多少少嘅資料俾大家啦。咁嗰隻船咧，其實就喺1月19日咧，就由喺香港嗰度咧，就有206個乘客咧就上咗船嘅。跟住就喺同一日咧就去咗南沙。去咗南沙之後咧，就喺南沙就有4480多名乘客上咗船。跟住依度總共4600多嘅乘客咧，就坐住架遊輪咧，就去咗越南，跟住就去到1月24日咧，依一架遊輪咧就翻去南沙。咁喺之前19日上船嗰4400多位內地嘅乘客咧，已經全部落曬船嘅喺南沙。咁再之後咧，依隻船就喺南沙就到港啦。之前19日嗰206位喺香港上船嘅乘客咧，都在24日在香港落船的。剛才陳處長都提過，現在在泊在啟德郵輪碼頭那艘船那 上面咧就有1800多位乘客啦，嚇、啊、咁其實大部分都係香港市民嚟嘅，嚇、啊、咁其實呢1800多個乘客咧，而家喺船上面咧係絕對冇任何直接嘅接觸同之前頭先提過嗰8個確診患者嘅，因為嗰8個確診患者同佢接觸過嗰啲乘客咧，已經全部喺24號落曬船噶啦。咁或者我再交代翻究竟港口衞生科做咗啲咩工作啦？咁我哋咧其實就收到通報之後咧，今朝早咧已經就港口衞生科咧就派咗一隊人員咧就上船嘅。咁咧就已經通知咗架船咧，其實喺冇衞生主任或者衞生署嘅許可之下咧，全部船員同埋全部乘客咧都係唔可以落船嘅。咁而家我哋嘅調查仲進行緊，所以咧到而家呢一刻為止咧，都冇任何船員或者冇任何乘客係落咗船嘅，嚇，係啦。咁咧除咗或者我一間再交代少少啦。咁我哋上咗船之後咧，我哋就會為每一位乘客同埋每一位員工咧，都收佢哋嘅健康申報表，同埋咧同埋做呢、這個體温監測。咁暫時我哋嘅工作主要都喺幫啲員工度做緊，因為都幾多人，成3000多人。咁我哋就幫咗個1800多人個員工咧，就做咗調查。咁初步了解咧，有30位到嘅員工咧，就喺佢哋嘅健康申報表咧，就話佢哋自己曾經出現過病徵，曾經有3位咧係話自己出現過發燒嘅。當中有一位咧話曾經出現過發燒嘅船員咧，喺船上邊佢攞過一個樣本，已經對乙型流感係呈陽性反應嘅。但係基於審慎嘅態度咧，我哋都將呢3位船員咧，就喺我哋衛生主任嘅許可之下，就俾佢落咗船，就已經將3位嘅船員咧送咗去聯合醫院。同埋威爾斯醫院進行隔離同埋測試嘅嚇，咁、我哋而家嘅調查咧仍然係進行緊，咁另外27位咧嗰啲曾經出現嗰啲輕微病徵嘅咧，大部分都係只係有咳嗽或者係有喉嚨痛嘅症狀，咁我哋啲同事咧而家就喺船上邊咧就幫呢27位嘅員工咧。就攞一啲樣本，跟住就會送去我哋衛生署衛生防護中心公共衛生檢測中心裏邊度測試新型冠狀病毒嘅，係啦。咁另外咧，就之前都提過啦，有1月24號咧，有206個人咧曾經有機會接觸過嗰啲確診個案嘅咧，已經落咗船嘅香港。咁我哋已經同船公司咧。攞咗相關依206個人嘅資料，我哋已經就盡快咁樣做緊一個接觸者追蹤嘅工作嚇。咁根據我哋而家嘅風險評估啦嚇，咁都之前有8個確診嘅個案啦，而都有唔少嘅員工咧都有啲病徵出現咗嚇。為審慎起見咧，我哋認為咧呢一隻船咧，我哋雖然調查都進行緊。我哋都會根據我哋之後攞咗啲樣本嗰個報告，同埋我哋流行病學調查所得到嘅結果，去再決定會有啲乜嘢再一步嘅衛生檢疫措施。咁我哋係唔排除會係將成架船做一個檢疫嘅情況嘅。
而家係提問嘅時間，請希望提問嘅記者先舉手，嗌咗你之後咧，請你先介紹自己嘅傳媒機構，即係發問嘅。前面呢位記者，
係林太你好，香港01嘅。咁你琴日就講到話你有出到內部指引咧，要負責前線或者去人多密集地方嘅公務員先可以戴口罩啦，就係為咗慳啲使，留翻俾一啲醫護人員去用嘅。但係醫管局聯網服務總監楊帝剛咧就已經講咗話咧，從來都冇收過呢個由懲教署工場生產嘅口罩啦。咁想請問翻咧，你口中所講話預留俾醫護嘅口罩究竟去咗邊咧？係俾咗啲咩部門去 去用呢？同埋你頭先有解釋到話，琴日嘅言論咧係要主要官員去以身作則去減低呢個用量啦。根據衞生嘅風險原則去決定係咪戴口罩嘅。咁我想問點解在場嘅官員係有啲戴有啲唔戴咧？那個標準究竟係點樣咧？會唔會擔心仍然去要求公務員去減低用量嘅話，會持續引起佢哋嘅反彈咧？同埋都想問翻，會唔會考慮分發政府嘅口罩儲備俾市民？因為有很多其實長者啊、長期病患啊，都是已經沒有口罩的供應，咁會唔會考慮優先分發啲口罩俾佢哋去以佢哋應急咧？
唔該曬，我想差不多了。
我回答部分啦，然後因為整體口罩嗰個供應，我哋而家做緊嘅工作咧，我請阿邱騰華局長可以補充嘅。第一咧就係、是、懲教署係一個喺香港有生產嘅口罩嘅地方嚇、啊，就佢嘅生產量咧唔多嘅嚇、啊，即使而家我哋要求佢提產咧都唔多嘅，所以喺過往日子咧，懲教署主要係供應翻俾有關嘅部門用，同埋有少部分咧係俾一啲非政府機構咧嚟到去訂購。我哋應該喺昨天嘅一個 Team Talk 裏面咧，都俾咗大家嗰個數字噶啦。當我講話我哋希望節省啲嚟用，去俾預留俾多啲嘅醫護人員咧，呢啲醫護人員亦都係包括喺政府裏面嘅醫護人員，同埋喺前線要需要因為提供服務嘅醫護嘅人員或者其他嘅同事。不過如果大家睇整體嘅口罩供應咁緊絕嘅時候，當醫管局去訂購嚟到俾醫護人員用咧，而家我哋都一併嚟到睇噶啦，即係唔係話醫管局自己去訂咧就可以買得到，因為全球都緊絕，喺內地亦都係緊絕，咁所以對於口罩供應咧已經係整個公營部門咧，我哋一併嚟到睇，甚至早期咧大家都記得，對於私營嘅部門，如果去訂購咗出現咗運送嘅問題、出關嘅問題咧，我哋都係幫緊。咁所以如果我哋能夠將整體嘅政府嘅用量可以稍微減低咧，就令到嗰個整體嘅供應裏面可以俾醫管局嘅醫護人員或者其他前線嘅醫護人員咧可以有得使用。第二方面咧，我哋同樣係非常之關心長者弱勢社群喺安老院舍裏面照顧者佢嘅口罩嘅需要，我哋亦都係鼓勵慈善機構啦。同埋有啲人話捐俾我哋咧，我哋都鼓勵佢應該係捐俾呢啲需要有口罩用嘅弱勢嘅社群嚟到去使用啊！我呢度請阿邱局長或者再整體講講個情況。
好啊，多謝行政長官。市民對於嗰、那個口罩嗰個需求係好大，亦都我哋體諒明白，即係嗰個緊張嘅情緒。正如行政長官所講咧，答翻呢位記者嘅問題咧，我哋近日即係就住一啲保護物資，包括口罩嘅供應咧，政府內部做一個檢視。我哋呢個檢視係同醫管局一起做，因為確實咧自從喺過年之後咧，全球對於呢啲保護物資嗰個需求好大。亦都咧係個別嘅外地啦，或者外國嘅國家咧，亦都有部分咧係對於呢物資咧係進行出口嘅管制。咁因此咧，傳統嗰種即係採購嘅方法，無論係即係醫管局直接去購買，或者係我哋透過物料供應處直接購買咧，傳統嗰種招標方法咧，其實係唔可行噶啦。咁所以咧，我哋亦都有主動去接觸包括內地同埋外地嘅一啲供應商，希望可以用直接嘅方式去購買。咁我哋喺做呢個工作嘅時候，係同埋醫管局一齊去做嘅。喺嗰個需求方面咧，我哋都睇得到咧，就係以醫管局，尤其是即係前線醫護人員，亦都包括政府嘅即係衞生署嘅前線醫護人員咧，佢哋對呢啲保護衣物嗰個需求咧係增加得好快，係以十倍計咁樣增加。咁呢個係合理嘅，因為佢哋都需要有呢啲保護衣物先至能夠做到佢嘅工作，亦都係保護自己、保護病人。咁因此咧，我哋喺呢個工作上面聯同一線去做。個目的咧，好似頭先行政長官所講啦，我哋採購到嘅咧，我哋優先一定會係俾前線嘅醫護人員，無論佢喺即係醫管局或者係衛生署工作，一樣係咁樣。我哋都希望綜合去處理。我哋亦都明白到咧，就係而家目前嗰、那個採購情況咧，就係、是、各地都緊張，價格都即係升咗好多。但係我哋就希望即係將個網 拉得闊一啲。除咗政府自己嘅採購之外咧，我哋亦都有同商界、進口同埋零售商一齊去討論。如果有一啲係佢哋落咗單，確實尤其是喺內地係可以即係已經可以付運嘅，但係因為種種原因出現問題嘅時候咧，我哋過往係會透過海關與海關係幫佢手，亦都近。自從即係農曆年過後咧，我哋都見到有一啲呢類嘅供應咧恢復翻嚟香港。但係我哋亦都覺得長遠嚟講仲要做多啲工作。咁所以我哋近期亦都即係主動去接觸一啲內地生產商，睇下可唔可以即係就住香港嘅供應咧係能夠確保一啲，亦都可能要同中央去處理。因為確實喺內地嗰個疫情嘅情況之下咧，佢哋對於呢啲物資嗰個需求咧係同香港一樣咁迫切嘅，咁所以喺中間要有啲協調功夫，咁呢方面我哋仍然係做緊，亦都就住喺香港嗰個零售嘅層面嚟講咧，我亦都有同零售商去討論，用啲乜嘢嘅方式喺佢有貨到嘅時候咧，如果個價位即係唔好令到市民太唔方便嘅方式去做，咁呢個我哋係同大小嘅供應商同埋零售商咧係討論呢方面嘅問題。最後一方面嚟講咧，亦都有近期亦都好多人咧係話香港係咪可以做一啲少量，但係較為係持續嘅本地生產。咁我哋亦都聯同咧呢個生產力促進局咧係將嗰個生產線嘅一啲基本嘅資料同埋要需要嘅生產情況咧係聚合咗。我哋亦都會同即係有興趣做呢方面嘅生產商咧喺香港設廠呢方面咧係做一啲研究。咁所以多方面去做確實係。困難嘅，咁但係我哋仍然都朝住頭先我所講嗰幾個方向去繼續去工作。唔該。
下一條，綠色衫櫃。
係幾位你哋好，新城電台㗎。係啊，首先咧想問一下咧，即係香港咧，啱啱都提到啦，喺短時間之內其實都多咗好幾宗嘅本地感染個案啦。其實到今日咧先去決定強制隔離內地入境嘅人士，係咪會唔會已經係太遲咧？林太，你覺得咧自己需唔需要為即係保障市民不力去負責咧？另外想問一下咧，強制即係內地入境旅客接受檢疫嗰部分咧，咁因為佢哋未必有固定的住處噶嘛，實行上會唔會有困難呢？如果安排他哋入住嗰啲檢疫中心，又係咪真係有位置俾佢哋即係容納到咁多人呢？唔該。
第二個問題咧，我請陳肇始教授講講。不過正如我剛才喺開場白講咧，我哋嗰、那個有關嘅規例仲係草擬，規例嘅詳情咧可能要過兩日，我哋先可以同大家介紹。但係初步嘅檢疫嘅模式嘅安排咧，陳局長可以講講嘅。我頭先喺開場白都講過啦，喺今次應對疫情方面咧，我哋採取嘅策略一直都係希望可以預防同埋減少病毒感染傳播為目的。而在整個過程裏面，即係自1月1號到而家咧，我哋都係不斷咁按住疫情嘅變化，徵詢咗專家嘅意見，然後顧及香港嘅實際情況咧，作出相應嘅調整。啊，調整嘅頻密度，即係一輪又一輪又一輪，以至到調整嘅力度咧，都係越嚟越嚴厲。呢、這個亦都係符合按住疫情嘅不斷變化咧，而提升我哋嗰個迅速應變嘅措施。或者一陣我請衛生署署長講講呢個嘅策略同埋呢啲嘅措施咧，我哋都係以科學嘅根據同埋以專家嘅意見咧嚟到去制定。咁所以就至於呢個係咪從我哋即係公共衞生嘅角度係一個最適切嘅措施咧，我諗啊揾專家講講咧係最好啦。咁我喺呢度請或者陳教授先講咗第二部分有關於第日要強制檢疫嘅時候嗰、那個框架。是怎樣做啊？但詳細的情形，正如我所講咧，最好是再過多兩日到咧，我哋同大家再介紹。
好，多謝行政長官。咁其實咧，剛才行政長官都講咗啦，這個咧我哋都會有一個法律嘅框架嘅，咁係會由2月8日咧就凌晨零時起，咁就係規定咧係所有從內地抵港嘅人士，咁無論係乜嘢口岸。入境的人士，亦都唔論係香港居民或者咧係非香港居民，咁都必須咧係接受一個強制嘅檢疫。 14天，咁期間咧係不能夠離境。咁當然咧，佢哋如果喺抵港前14天去到曾經去到內地咧，當然亦都係必須咧係進行強制嘅檢疫嘅。咁我都特別咧係強調呢個而家係一個框架，我哋嘅細節咧係會稍後交代。咁亦都要強調咧，喺呢啲人士喺入境嘅時候咧，佢哋仍然咧都會係有健康申報啦，亦都會有體温嘅檢測啦，咁同埋咧佢哋咧係冇病徵嘅。
請啊，
好就新嘅冠狀病毒呢個疾病咧係一個新嘅微生物。咁喺去年十二月底嘅時候咧，當香港政府係得悉喺武漢有一啲不明原因嘅肺炎嘅時候咧，我哋香港嘅專家已經同政府咧係緊密聯絡。咁呢一隻新嘅病毒咧，初期的而且確嚟講咧，可以掌握嘅資料咧係有限。咁透過內地國際上好多嘅專家嘅合作同埋研究咧，我哋對呢個病毒嘅資料咧係越嚟越多，咁所以喺防控措施嗰度咧，亦都會隨住我哋對呢個病毒嘅認識係會有演變嘅。咁所以喺初期嚟講咧，個傳播途徑啊，咩時候個潛伏期啊，喺潛伏期間會唔會有一啲病人係可能冇病徵喺社區？都有機會感染啊！人同人嘅之間嘅傳播能力咧，大家都會記得咧。我哋嘅科學家咧，都係透過唔停嘅研究咧，係將嗰個資料咧係越嚟越掌握到嘅。咁所以喺疫情嗰個防控措施咧，亦都會因應呢啲咁嘅資料咧嚟到調節。咁我相信而家隨住多咗資料咧，我哋知道呢個病毒嘅傳播咧係有機會喺個社區嗰度都會有一啲冇病徵嘅病人。咁所以專家亦都好早嘅時期咧已經提醒我哋咧，而世界衛生組織亦都講到咧，其實喺每一個社區、世界唔同嘅地方咧出現有本地嘅個案咧係唔出奇嘅。咁所以我哋嘅防疫措施咧一定要全香港上下齊心一齊做。在個人衛生嗰方面啦，當我哋而家知道呢個病毒可能喺環境嗰度，例如早時喺內地一啲研究喺個門病嗰度都有嘅，咁所以我哋個人衛生咧個手部衛生咧就尤其重要啦。有研究顯示到嗰個病人嘅糞便裏邊咧都帶有呢個病毒，咁所以我哋就再三強調喺嗰個處理，譬如洗手間、沖廁所嘅時候要冚住個廁所先沖啦，又例如喺我哋嘅屋裏邊嗰個 U 型嗰、那個。去水器咧，必定要入咗啲水，防止一啲倒灌嘅情況咧。呢啲措施、呢啲宣傳咧，我哋要加強，亦都每一個市民喺你哋日常嘅生活、個人嘅習慣，同埋喺嗰個環境嘅措施嗰度咧，都要配合，咁先至有機會咧減低呢只病毒喺香港嘅傳染嘅。
Let's take some English question now. Gentlemen here.
Thank you. Hello again, Mrs. Land. John Ray from ITV News, ITN of the UK. Could I ask you please to answer this general political question? Aren't you open to the accusation of always running behind this outbreak? That if you'd had acted sooner, then Hong Kong would have been safer? And how worried are you now that the direction of this outbreak in this territory might end up with Hong Kong beingin the same kind of isolation trouble that the mainland of China is. Two American airlines have already cancelled flights. Taiwan, the Philippines are, you know, closing their borders to you. So how worried are you that this might well end up with Hong Kong in isolation? Thank you.
Well, first of all, John,As I have said in my introductory remarks, since we were first notified of this virus in the last month or so, we have been very vigilant in monitoring the situation, taking into account the advice of my in-house experts as well as external experts who were subsequently appointed to the Chief Executive's Expert Advisory Panel towards the latter part of January.So we have taken into account all these factors in making sure that the strategy remains one to prevent and to reduce the chances of this infection in Hong Kong, and also to adopt the measures which are most needed at every stage of the situation. because the situation changed, as the Director of Health has just explained to you. So it is not entirely appropriate to say that one was behind or one was ahead of the various timelines in order to introduce the effective measures. The second thing is about whether I am worried or we are worried. I suppose everybody in Hong Kong should be worried about the situation in Hong Kong. So in my concluding remarks just now, I made a strong appeal that first, let's have confidence in Hong Kong. We have a very robust public health system. We have excellent medical and health personnel. I should add that we also have adequate public resources, and we have a population which has gone through several of these infectious diseases. So they should be more alert to the various precautionary measures that the Center for Health Promotion has asked them to comply with. So this is a time really for social cohesion, for getting our act together in order to fight this disease. One of my expert advisors was a former Assistant Director General of the World Health Organization, Professor Fukuda. In my meeting with him over this period, especially yesterday, he made this a very strong point that in every society, every community, in order to combat a public health crisis, it requires society to put aside the differences in order to act together. You can imagine if we roll out one measure after another, including controlling the border points, reducing traffic, or now going for mandatory quarantine, if members of the community refuse to comply or refuse to adopt the various precautionary measures and still want to go out and interact, that would create difficulties for our fight against this disease. I remain optimistic that with the favorable circumstances, the experience that we have gained in the past, that we should able to fight this together. But here I make another very sincere appeal that this is really the time for us to put aside our differences, to act together in order to overcome this public health crisis.
Let's take one more English question first. Having away.
Ms. Lam, do you think that your way of tackling the virus is more reactive than proactive and preventive? And how exactly are you going to quarantine potentially tens of thousands of people coming back from the mainland? And why do you think that this would be a more effective and feasible way of tackling the outbreak of the virus than closing the border completely? And secondly, just yesterday you said that officials can only wear masks when necessary. And I see that some officials present here today are wearing masks and some are not wearing masks. Can you explain why?
Well, I forgot to answer your second question when it was asked by another reporter friend here. Well, in our internal guidelines, and also in guidelines issued by the World Health Organization or by our own Center for Health Protection, there are circumstances which individuals are advised to wear surgical masks. So it is not a complete ban on wearing of masks. So there are circumstances that the advice is to put on a surgical mask, including if that individual is unwell. I'm sorry to see that several of my colleagues are unwell. And of course, there may be a case that because they are in frequent interactions in a health setting, so even if they are not unwell, because I've not checked Dr. Leung whether he is unwell now, that puts him into that sort of circumstances that he should wear a surgical mask. So I think we are acting consistently with the guidelines that we have adopted not only for the government, but for the general population. The first question about the way that we are tackling this public health situation. As I have said, the public health situation or this virus infection situation is evolving all the times. It started off with something which is entirely unknown. So even in early January when we amend or when we made a regulation under the Prevention and Control of Diseases Ordinance, we didn't even know that it is coronavirus We just put in a term to try to describe this very unknown virus that was hitting on the mainland of China and also Hong Kong and other places all over the world. So the situation is one that is evolving. So our strategy is really to monitor very closely the situation, taking into account the scientific evidence, the expert advice of my in-house colleagues as well as external experts, and to devise the most suitable strategy and measures that will help us to tackle the situation. And we have not shied away from introducing these effective measures. So you may remember that on one occasion, I think 2 days ago, I said you should not be surprised if you would be seeing me again within a very short period of time, because we need to have a speedy response to the changing circumstances. So I don't want to particularly describe how well my government has been doing, but certainly we are acting in accordance with a strategy which is to protect the safety and the health of Hong Kong.
下一條，前面呢位。
有線電視想問多少少咧，經內地嘅人要隔離嗰度，其實而家會唔可以透露多少少具體嘅措施咧？因為相信可能市民都比較擔心，就係預計實施之後，其實會有幾多呢啲嘅人係要隔離咧？因為見到而家其實都有成萬人係咁樣出入，係咪真係處理到咧？咁同埋即係到底個方式會係在家定係入境咧？即係例如外國人會俾咩地方佢啦？如果香港人在家嘅話，係咪即係會俾一啲手環佢？又夠唔夠呢啲嘅手環咧？咁另外就係呢個措施其實二月八日先落實啦，咁但係會唔會擔心呢兩日好多人可能趁呢個時間會有大批人入境？咁如果啲人又冇病徵嘅話，會唔會即係對個社區都潛在風險咧？同埋，假如我哋即係呢啲措施其實早多十日、廿日就實施，其實預計到其實會唔會比而家嘅情況好啲咧？點解即係會而家等到個疫情過咗之後先至推出呢一個措施，係咪太遲咧？咁第三就係都係想問翻醫護人員嗰度啦。林太之前就講過咧，就話要開心建成。咁但係其實醫護人員都有多次要求想同你公開對話，想問下點解即係冇去出席？
唔該。我答咗第三個問題啦，然後請陳教授講講嗰個情況。就喺醫管理局裏邊一個工會嚇，佢要採取呢啲工業行動啊，或者唔返回工作崗位咧，呢、這個一定係喺個機構裏邊係個人事管理嘅議題。咁所以我上一次都係咁樣回應，就係話最適合應該係由醫院管理局嘅高層，包括醫院管理局嘅主席同埋行政總裁咧，係同你哋見面嚇。行政總裁亦都係會將佢哋嘅意見向我反映嚇。咁所以我覺得既然行政總裁亦都同我哋見過面，亦都係好願意繼續同我哋見面，呢個係合適嘅形式。但係另一個考慮咧，就係我有留意工會嘅訴求。個目標其實同我哋冇乜大嘅分歧，從嗰個公共衛生嗰個防控嘅角度，我哋都係希望能夠減低人流，壓縮呢啲跨境嘅人次，從而令到我哋可以更加防止病毒嘅傳播啦，亦都當然可以減少醫院管理局嗰個嘅工作嘅壓力。咁所以我哋係有知道佢哋有咩訴求，我哋就循住呢個訴求咧，不斷喺度做緊嘢。又等於佢哋話要確保有足夠嘅防護物資，包括口罩啊、防護衣。呢、這個亦都係我多次反覆強調咧，我哋會將醫護人員，包括前線嘅工作嘅人員，佢哋呢方面嘅需求咧擺喺首位。咁所以其實佢哋好多嘅訴求咧，我哋都有聽到，亦都係喺我哋嘅工作嘅範圍裏邊嘅。我請阿陳教授講講有關於檢疫嗰、那個。工作
好啊，或者我都即係都講一講個框架。我剛才咧都所講啦，就話具體嘅安排咧，我哋都會稍後咧就係、是、會詳細咧同大家交代嘅。但最緊要咧就係、是、第一咧，我哋都會係提供一個訂立一個新嘅附屬法例。咁呢個就令到我哋咧係可以提供一個法律嘅框架，對於呢一種係強制自我檢疫嘅安排咧，係可以有一個法律嘅框架。第二咧就係喺我哋啲口岸咧，一般嚟講咧，所有嘅口岸嚇，而家入境嘅人士咧，其實佢係香港居民同埋唔係香港居民咧，都係需要接受強制嘅檢疫14日。 咁剛才行政長官都講過，喺我哋入境嘅人士咧，我哋都發現咧，其實係大部分咧都係香港嘅人士，要係喺兩地咁樣往還啦。咁其餘例如係內地嘅或者係其他國家嚟嘅咧，嗰、那個咧都係屬於一個少數。咁但係咧亦都係會。不同的是香港居民或者是非香港居民呢是都會有這個強制的一個檢疫了。當然呢整體來說呢如果說我們的詳細細節呢我們會稍後交代但是那個重要的地方呢就是即是令到大家知道呢現在因為在內地那個疫情呢都是嚴峻的。而我在香港來說呢我們也都是發現呢是有幾宗的這些本地的感染的個案也都是我們有理由相信呢這些本地感染的個案呢可能會是更多的所以我們必須呢都要採取一些果斷的措施呢是去令到一些有機會有風險的人呢他是都會有一個強制的一個檢疫咁當然，除咗呢一啲嘅強制檢疫之外咧，我哋亦都有一啲其他嘅措施嘅啊。例如咧，我哋除咗話我哋自己喺個口岸嗰度繼續會有健康申報，亦都係會有一個體温監測，亦都係有我哋港口衛生科嘅同事之外咧。例如大家都會覺得，如果而家我哋係有一啲喺本地嘅一啲嘅感染嘅個案咧，咁亦都因應呢、這個出現咧，喺社區感染嗰個嘅風險咧，其實咧都係會增加。咁所以醫管局咧，亦都係為開設一啲指定診所咧，係作好咗準備噶啦。咁亦都會適時咧係啟動各個聯網嘅指定診所，去配合咧醫院去處理較大量一啲嘅疑似個案啊，或者跟進嘅工作。咁當然係希望減低急症室嘅一啲嘅服務壓力。咁而呢啲嘅指定診所咧，一般咧都會負責處理一啲病況係比較輕微嘅個案啦，令到咧係醫院同埋急症室咧可以集中咁處理咧一啲較為嚴重嘅個案。咁而呢啲指定診所咧，亦都係可以協助喺社區咧揾到係一啲可能感染嘅個案，進一步咧去減低社區傳播嘅機會。咁我哋聽日咧都會有記者會咧，係交代相關嘅細節咧同埋安排。
我想或者補充一句咧，就係當然我哋而家坐喺度咧，係冇辦法好精準咁話俾大家聽，最終呢個措施生效之後，會有幾多入境嘅市民或者係遊客或者係旅客係需要接受呢個強制嘅檢疫。但是這個措施是相當嚴厲的，你一入境香港呢是需要有14日的檢疫、如果我們看回過去，我們只是透過整合口岸，即是說未去到有人身的即受到影響，只是不方便而已，即是你刪了 ABC 口岸它就去 DEF 口岸，我連 DE 口岸都刪了，它就是 F 口岸。數字顯示呢，在1月29號即是說未第一批的口岸都未暫緩服務之前呢，就是所有的經過陸路海路口岸入境香港呢是17,991 人，去到昨天已經下降到28,675 人，即是說已經是得回不夠兩成。所以我相信我們其實由今天開始講了，說在星期六凌晨零時如果是入境，將會是需要接受強制的檢疫14天呢，這個數字一定是會下降的、這個是常理、誰人會願意、由內地入境然後被我們要強制、檢疫他兩個禮拜那麼久呢、所以在這裡呢就我們從這個角度去看呢，是不應該需要處理很大量的強制檢疫的人數的。不過都是這樣說，尤其是香港居民，因為現在八成多入境的都是香港居民，再有萬幾個香港居民呢是每日咁出境，所以在這裡都要呼籲所有的香港居民都要齊心，都要一起呢來對配合這個策略來對抗疫。只要香港居民呢是減少或者甚至最好不去內地或者其他疫情的地區呢，這個問題就容易處理了。
但當然我們明白這個也是剛才有位記者朋友為什麼要預留兩天呢，因為事實上由於兩地的、人民那個聯繫或者有其他很多的翻工、或者照顧、親友、照顧幼童、所以我們也都明白如果有一些具體的問題呢，政府能夠多一些可以支援，多一些可以配套呢，就令到他們 不離境不入境可能是比較安心一些。所以我剛才都說我會是要求勞工及福利局局長呢在這裡要制定一些方案，或者在這裡請羅局長簡單講你會做的工作。
多謝特首。我想大家明白到呢，即如果你純粹來香港旅行幾日但要運14日，我相信旅遊的人都很少來，但最重要我在我工作範圍最關心的是兩種的人，一種就是跨境工作的人士和一些跨境的家庭，他們事實上都是可能是有必須是來往內地和香港的。不過大家都知道，就算在過往一個星期，不論受影響的即係僱員同埋僱主咧，都已經會考慮到員工喺兩地來回嗰啲嘅風險㗎啦。咁如果我哋喺嚟緊呢個星期六實施由內地回港係需要接受呢個檢疫14天嘅話咧，不論佢係喺內地生活而每日係翻嚟香港工作，又或者係香港生活每日都要到內地工作嘅員工咧，係都會受到影響嘅。而呢未來兩天嘅時間咧，就正可以咧係俾呢啲嘅僱員有空間作出適當的安排，所以我們是會很積極去研究一些方案。如果有一些是未能有適當的工作的安排，如果即譬如說不能夠留在家工作而受影響的跨境的僱員呢，會提供一些所需要的協助的。剛才說還有第二類，就是跨境的家庭，正如剛才特首所說，有些跨境是要照顧家人，譬如他的父母要照顧一些幼兒，咁你未來呢兩日呢亦都係同時呢係提供一個空間俾呢啲家庭作出適當嘅安排。當然如果佢真係到最後都係遇到一啲不能夠解決困難呢，有需要嘅時候呢，社福利處係可以提供一啲嘅協助。咁當然有需要嘅家庭呢可以致電社署嘅熱線2343-2255尋求協助嘅。多謝。
最後兩條黑色樓位。後面黑色樓位。女士，不好意思。
林太，你好明報的，想請問呢，即政府會不會考慮即徵用迪士尼的酒店或者以期的空地，甚至是石崗部分的軍營作為一個隔離或者檢疫的中心啦？第二，雖然你剛才都提到就是你剛才都提到就是說會給一些時間啲跨境的家庭和學童啦，但是會不會擔心有些人是趁這兩日的空檔就湧來香港，增加了即香港社區爆發的個風險呢？麻煩。
第一個問題呢，就我哋係仍然好積極咁去尋找緊一啲嘅方案嚟到增加呢啲檢疫中心嘅設施。目前為止呢，仍然係嗰三個嘅度假營，我哋已經係去接觸緊好多所有呢啲度假營，因為似乎度假營嘅位置呢一般市民都比較能夠接受，咁但係我都要喺呢度擺即係做個附註呢，好多度假營不是很適合的，由於它那個或者房間獨立的房間很少，或者是根本不是容易車可以到達，但我們每一個都去看。另外呢，也都是要求發展局呢在這裡研究緊，如果有些吉地是否也都可以透過某一種方法呢來增建這些設施，但今日呢我們未能夠跟大家公布詳細有些什麼額外的地方呢可以做這些中心，但是有一個現成應該在幾日內，本來應該幾日內能夠可以啟動呢，就是在饒宗頤文化館，所以我在這裡再次呼籲呢，就地區的人士希望以一個包容理解的態度呢，讓我們盡快可以啟動這個文化館的設施，因為它會將對我們的檢疫中心能夠可以做的容量呢是有一個挺好的增長在這裡的。至於剛才我哋話係去到星期六凌晨零時生效，主要好似阿羅志光局長講咧，因為喺呢啲跨境嘅人次裏面咧，相信去到呢個時候，大部分都係有一個實際嘅需要啦， 即係我真係覺得會可能未必仲有人去旅遊嚇。咁所以既然每日仲有咁多香港居民跨境啊，咁佢一定係有個實際需要啦。咁所以都要預留一個時間俾佢嚟去處理佢哋嘅實際嘅問題嚇。至於會唔會製造到一個嘅空檔？睇嚟又未必會，因為我哋睇到剛才就算你整合口岸，亦都有人擔心咁啊，其他用緊其他口岸嘅會唔會湧曬嚟呢個口岸呢？因為如果佢要嚟，佢就會嚟，又冇乜發生過嚇。剩翻嗰兩個口岸嘅人次咧，喺昨天第一日咧，亦都係冇明顯增加得好多嚇，冇話接收曬喺羅湖啊，或者係落馬洲支線嚟嗰啲。咁所以即係尤其是而家大家都知道咧，無論係喺內地或者香港，都係有呢個嘅風險喺度嚇。咁所以喺呢一方面咧，我哋平衡咗咁多嘅考慮，就係作咗呢個嘅安排。當然，除咗係俾受影響嘅人士有一定嘅好短暫嘅時間作出呢個即係安排咧，我哋亦都有一啲法律工作，同埋有一啲關於檢疫嘅營運嘅工作咧嚟到要處理。因為如果是生效之後未能夠處理呢個檢疫嗰、那個強制檢疫的安排咧，可能對於公共衛生的防護咧，亦都唔係一個即係最佳嘅選擇。
最後一條，第二排嗰位男記者。
Mr. Slam, South China Morning Post, you highlighted the need to reduce contacts in the community, and you announced earlier that civil service. Will work from home until February 9th. It's only a few days away from that day. Will you extend further that arrangement? And second question is, a friend of my colleague, who is a public hospital doctor, said the isolation ward in Princess Margaret Hospital have been occupied. Are there any other measures the government is going to adopt to handle this? Thank you.
Thank you very much for the question. Yes, we need to enhance social distancing as this is one of the important strategies now, especially we are seeing some community-based infection. I am not yet in a position to announce the exact arrangements for civil service after this week, but it is likely that we will have to extend it. But of course, again, it is a matter of balancing because many people in Hong Kong or many operation of businesses still require some very essential and basic services. So, but as I now see it, because I said the next 2 weeks will be rather critical, so there is a high chance that we will have to extend this work from home arrangement, and we will announce it as soon as possible. As far as the isolation ward in the Princess Margaret Hospital, in fact, it is not just isolation ward. The hospital authority has been under extreme pressure in almost everything, in terms of facilities, in terms of manpower, in terms of supplies, in the protective equipment, including surgical masks. So we are doing whatever the hospital authority needs to help them to overcome this shortage. And that's why I really make an appeal that staff of the hospital authority at this very critical juncture and very challenging times should continue to support the hospital authority as well as other healthcare professionals who are now working so hard in order to ensure the provision of services. But whether we have very specific proposals to tackle the isolation facilities, I see whether Professor Chan has something to add to that.
Okay, first of all, the as far as the current isolation facilities is concerned, its occupancy is about 40%. The hospital authority, other than the Princess Margaret Hospital ID block, that is the infection disease block, there are also other isolation facilities in in a number of hospitals in these seven clusters of the hospital authority. So this is something that obviously the hospital authority is looking at, and also at almost like real time monitoring and see how they can work towards the increasing number of cases. On the other hand, in order to relieve or the hospital authority capacity and to provide them with a situation, in particular the accident and emergency department, they are quite ready to embark on the designated clinic, the running of the designated clinic, because as we are seeing these cases in the community that is that may not have a previous travel history. So we are very vigilant in terms of looking at there may be cases already, you know, in the community, community infections. And in order to further reduce the risk of community transmission, then it is important for the hospital authority to actually identify, to continue to contain, you know, the situation and have an early identification of the cases. And so the designated clinic will be tackling cases that have of a milder situation, and so that allow the hospital as well as the accident and emergency departments to treat and to deal with the more severe cases and also the suspected cases. And so these designated clinic objective would be able to find or identify some of these cases in the community that may have the virus so as to reduce the community transmission chance. So we will be having more details, you know, for all of you about the designated clinic. The hospital authority is ready, but then we would have to look into when is the best time to execute or start the running of the designated clinic. So we will be having further information tomorrow.
今日記者會到呢度，多謝大家。
是否後知後覺和對疫情不上心呢？14天那個強制的